Today, I'm explaining how to get the most out of Dream Machine, an AI video generation tool by today's sponsor, Luma AI, that allows you to take ordinary footage and completely reimagine it. It's packed with a ton of creative value, but it can fall flat if not used effectively. Let me show you some of the best use cases, the most effective workflows, and some of the insane creations that I've come up with. When you log in, the layout is simple. On the left, you'll see boards where you can organize projects, clips, and ideas. Ideas is where you can use Ray to generate fresh images and videos from scratch. And Editor is where you can upload your own clips to transform them with Modify Video. Its basic workflow is one of Dream Machine's major strengths. You can do everything all in one place without bouncing between different apps. The feature that I've been most impressed with is Modify Video. It lets you upload your own video and then completely reimagine it without losing the original motion. For example, here's a clip of me walking in my yard with a stick. Now here it is again, reimagined where I'm a knight in a medieval setting. Here is the simple workflow for how I did it with Luma AI. I went into Editor and uploaded the clip. You can use clips up to 10 seconds long, but I find that 5 seconds or less is more reliable. With the clip open, I clicked on Modify, and a box popped up at the bottom for me to specify the details. From here, I just typed in the box. A royal knight walks by a medieval blacksmith shop with his new sword in hand. Cinematic. I clicked on the strength slider at the bottom, and for this generation, I decided to increase it a bit. But feel free to experiment with this. And then I just clicked the arrow. It takes a few minutes to process, which is understandable, but then you can see the output that it gave me. We'll upscale it to 4K HDR a little bit later on. I could even click now to modify the generated clip even further if I wanted to. But let's go back a sec. There are some more options that I want to show you. When modifying a clip, instead of just describing what I wanted to see in the box, I could have clicked on Modify Frame. From here, I can give a detailed explanation on what to change on the first frame of my video and quickly see the output. You can go through multiple of these until you get the one you like and then click Apply. Then you can just hit the arrow to modify the video with the new starting frame. This method allows you to see more options and go through more iterations before you decide on a final starting frame for your generated video. Additionally, when modifying a video, you can click on the three dots and then download the first frame of the original video to take into Photoshop or another AI application to custom modify the frame. Then you can come back in here to Luma AI, click on the plus start frame option, and upload your modified start frame. Now, when you generate a video, it will be based off of your custom modified start frame while still retaining the original video's motion. To finish off the night clip, I opened the clip up and clicked on the upscale HDR button. I chose 4K and HDR and then clicked Create. And again, here is the final version. The night clip wasn't the only thing that I experimented with, however. With just a few clicks, I completely transformed this office into a spaceship. My movements and actions stayed the same, but everything around me changed. I tried it on my cat and turned him into a snow leopard. And I love how the white stripe on his back, which is one of his most unique features, was retained in the snow leopard that we generated from his video. That absolutely made my day. Everyday objects work great as props. I turned a garden hose into a snake, and I even took a picture of a drink on my desk, and then I animated it using Dream Machine to look like it was spilling all over the desk, but that really didn't happen. That's the magic of Modify. You start with real footage and then just add some subtle changes, and it feels really natural. Here are a few things that I learned while testing. I mentioned using props. Giving the AI something physical to anchor to really improves the results of your video modifications. As I showed you earlier, make sure that you're stylizing the first frame of the video, then you don't really even have to enter a prompt. Just hit Modify and it will create the video with your new background. In painting also works, so you could take your first frame into Photoshop and just change some small details like adding an eye patch or changing a shirt, and then you can re-import that frame for a very controlled transformation. You may want to try filming in slow motion, so if you record at 60 frames per second, slow it down to 30 before uploading. It gives the AI more to work with and reduces the glitches and the fine detail, and it makes lip syncs far more accurate. On that note, I find that Luma AI works best when you're not trying to match up lip movement and facial features. AI in general still has a long way to go in this area. And remember, it's trial and error. Sometimes you get an absolutely crazy result, and then you need to go back and massage your prompts and continue trying until you get something that you're happy with. Dream Machine also has Reframe, which lets you resize and expand videos without awkward cropping. So if you film in 9x16 for, say, TikTok, you can easily upscale it to 16x9 for YouTube, and it intelligently fills in the missing details. And you can even upscale your videos from, say, 1080p to 4K right inside of Dream Machine, which is a great feature for when you're working on a high-end project. Now let's talk about Ray 3, Luma AI's newest model and one of the biggest updates to ever come to the platform. Ray 3 outputs in HDR, so you get richer colors, sharper frames, and more depth in highlights and shadows. It also adds a draft mode. This lets you quickly generate rough versions before committing credits to a polished render. Honestly, this is a feature that AI in general has needed for a long time. It allows you to experiment more freely, you save resources, you save money, and you can do things a lot faster. From my testing, Ray 3 is fantastic for generating environments, landscapes, and animating still photos. So my workflow has been Ray 2 for modify and Ray 3 for generation. That said, it's not perfect. Lip sync can still glitch, hands and eyes don't always render cleanly, and small details can break. But combined with the slow motion filming trick, you can minimize those issues and get some pretty production ready results. There are a couple limitations worth noting. You can only upload clips that are a max size of 100 megabytes, and you can only process videos for up to 10 seconds, which sounds really short, but in the modern editing environment where many cuts are only 3 or 4 seconds long, it actually gives you a lot of time to work with. Now, what about pricing? There's a free plan, which is great for testing, but you're stuck with draft quality, watermarks, and no commercial use. The light plan, which is $10 a month, has better resolution, no watermarks, but it's still for personal use only. The plus plan, which is $30 a month, is the sweet spot. Clean outputs, commercial rights, priority processing, and enough credits to build a real workflow. The unlimited plan is $95 a month and adds a relaxed mode for creators that are pushing out large volumes. There's also an enterprise plan, which is custom set up for large organizations. For me, the plus plan is the sweet spot. Light feels too restrictive, unlimited is overkill unless you're producing non-stop, but Plus provides the right balance of quality, features, and credits for you to use Dream Machine seriously. So just a quick recap. Modify video is where the magic happens. It lets you take some of your real footage and change whatever it is you want about it. Reframe allows you to upscale your videos and change them for different platforms. Ray 3 allows you to generate videos and images with HDR output. Make sure you're keeping your strength slider low if you want a more realistic output. Make sure you're filming in slow motion if you want the AI to do better with the small details. And expect a bit of trial and error before you get everything perfect. I plan to continue using Dream Machine for my own projects. It is an incredibly powerful content creation tool. If you want to try it yourself, there's a link down in the description of this video, and thanks again to Luma AI for sponsoring the video. And let me ask, what would you transform your office into using Dream Machine? Let me know in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm Anson Alexander. I am going to fly off into the next galaxy, and I'll see you in the next video.